Marshall County. Princeton High School, the Tigers take on their cross-county rivals, the Bluefield Beavers. Mom, this looks like to be a really tough game this evening.
Yeah, it really should. You've got a much improved Princeton team from last year. Bluefield, as always, powerhouse in double A. Princeton started off the year great, winning 80-7 against Whiteview. Bluefield going against their rivals, lost, though, 21-14 against Grand Virginia. So you know Bluefield's going to want to get on the winning side of the ball tonight. Bluefield lost more than just the game last week. They lost their starting quarterback.
Number two, Shane Johnson, makes the ball, brings it down the right side. He's perfect containment. He's at the 20, has a 15.
finishing off the number three, Jonathan Payne, for the Bluefield Beavers. And Payne is the only reason they didn't get a touchdown on the kickoff. He showed his speed and made that last-second tackle.
Yeah, that's the one thing we always expect out of Bluefield. They've got a lot of athletes on the field and always have a lot of speed.
Do not go away thinking this game is over. It has just started. Bluefield has a great tradition, and 7-0 is not going to knock them out of the ballgame.
Now, you know the coach is going to keep winning the game. It's, 1 minute gone. They've got plenty of time.
Just to put the ball up. It's short. Taken by number 18, Hercey. Hercey comes to his left and is knocked out of bounds. Right there. There's a flag in the field. He was met by number 21. The kicker, Costa, and knocked him out of bounds.
Watch on the West Virginia Army National Guard replay. They do a good job. He gets away from the initial tackler to the sideline, but Princeton does a good job. Him and a man bring him down. We got a foul, flag on the play.
It's a face mask penalty against the kicking team, against Princeton. Downfield and make the tackle, but Testa did it on that one for the Tigers.
And most of the time, you expect the kicker to stand back where he kicked the ball and wait for somebody to break free so he can come nowhere near tackling and show his lack of speed.
Here's our offense for Bluefield in our skill positions. Oops, we lost it. We lost it. We'll get those back up for you in a minute. Let's see what Bluefield's got in store for the Princeton Tigers. At quarterback, number 10, Eric McClanahan. He's a 6'1", 155-pound sophomore. A pitch out. Number 3, Jonathan Payne. Payne doesn't quit. He makes it around the right side. Breaks his aim and he's brought down in about a 5-yard gain.
Nice job by that Princeton offensive line.
Our offense for Bluefield, our quarterback once again, Eric McClanahan. Your halfback is Jonathan Payne. Number 22, the fullback, Alan Carter. Ansel Ponder and Mark Bagg are the wide receivers, and Cody Watson is your tight end. We are back at the line of scrimmage. It's second down. Look like about 5 to go on this one for Bluefield. Hand off to the big inside guy, the fullback. We just announced his name. Number 22. And he is a big boy to bring down, picked up for. Your offensive line, your tackle, Julian Morton, guard, Ryan Alford, the center, Alton Collins, Jeff Newman is the guard, and Tyrone Williams is your weak side tackle. Bluefield back out, they split number 31, Mark Page, wide to the left. Handoff to the halfback. Number 22, at fullback, number 22, Alan Carter. And it looks like he has enough for the first down.
Yeah, just a simple play, handoff up the middle.
The Bluefield will throw straight, everyday, ordinary, blue-collar, man-up-the-middle stuff on you. Your defense for Princeton, number 88, Cundiff, is a defensive end. Your tackles are Woods and Taylor, and the other defensive end is Ryan Tabor. A very experienced group this year. Out of the shotgun. Pass was Aaron's, intended for number 3, Jonathan Payne on that one. It'll bring up second down. No gain on that play. That looked like a little drop back pass setting up their blocking. Here's your defensive linebackers, Harold, Croy, and Gallimore for Princeton. And your defensive backfield, your cornerbacks, Johnson. Your safeties are Gardner and Hayes. And your other cornerback is Q Wilborn. And that's the defense for the Princeton Tigers. Second down, 10 yards. Pitch up, coming near side, and he leaps forward. Number 28, Maurice Jordan, the running back for Bluefield.
Bluefield's done a good job on the running game. Watch on the West Virginia Army National Guard replay. Keep the ball to the outside, let them use his speed. Just finding that opening. He does a good job right there. Pick up another 2 yards at the end of the play. That's going to be our third down and a long two, almost three. For Bluefield, but they've done a good job mixing it up inside, outside, and good blocking so far from the offensive line.
Great instant replays for our camera crew, and courtesy of the West Virginia Army Guard, 1-800 guard. Simple handoff up the middle of the big boy, number 22, Alan Carter, the fullback. I do not believe he made it for the first down.
And that was a great job by Princeton. The big guy, where do you want to hit him? Down around the knees, and that's what we did. We saw a lot of tackling last
Just make a wedge and say, stop us if you can.
That's right. That's showing a lot of strength. And if you're Bluefield, you got to be a little bit worried right now if they've been able to control the middle of that line, because we've seen Prince before, and they like to keep the ball on the ground. Quick handoff, number seven, Hayes. He goes around the left side this time. Wait for a drop, pulled outside. He's gone all the way. This is over. That's a great touchdown run. He's got a flag on the field. Right by where he made that nifty outside move, and you have a flag. And I think you're going to call a block in the back, and I don't necessarily know if I agree with that call. It looked like the defender was just getting out of the way.
It might have been somewhat caused by the running back himself making the inside move, maybe turning the defensive player, so it looks like the offensive player is actually blocking in the back, because he made a very nice move there, and that's what sprung it with that block.
He took a nice angle and cut through that hole and really got McClanahan out of position for Bluefield.
The only thing that stopped Princeton so far tonight has been Princeton.
That's right.
It has definitely not been the defense.
Yeah. Hayes did a great job hitting that. I mean, when he saw that opening, and it, you know, so many times we see running backs, they don't read their blockers correctly. He read his blocker excellent that time, cut inside that hole, and boy, when he did, he really turned the speed on, caught McClanahan out of position. But I think this is going to come back. Well, they're talking to Bluefield players right now.
If you're just joining us, we're at Hunnicutt Stadium in Princeton on a picture-perfect late summer Friday evening in southern West Virginia.
And I don't know if we've got that one on replay. Once you could,
I think we'll have it right. Once we get this call, he's marking it off currently.
We'll use the hands, blocking the back. That's going to be 10 yards from the spot of the foul. That's going to bring up a first and 14. Watch on the West Virginia Army National Guard replay. Now watch number 51. He's going to be the lead blocker out here. He's going to take the outside man. And boy, that's tough, because what happened was he was going out and he had the quarterback, and the quarterback says, I want no part of the offensive line, and turned away from him.
I think play this time to the right side. We'll try it again. This time number 52, the lead blocker. Boy, the running back.
Quarterback Belcher for Princeton. So as soon as he turned it upfield, he turned up and ran ahead of him. Number four. right on top of that, gone as he down. Looks on the West Virginia Army National Guard replay. And the official was in front of it, but I'm telling you, he had a better view than anybody else in the state. He wasn't more than 3 yards from him. Tyson, from our position, you could almost see it because you knew when he went down, I was thinking, oh, don't touch that knee. And he did because that ball was very hard to control. So just like that, that's two more points on the board for Princeton, making it 9-0. And they should get the ball back in pretty good field position. They're now discussing things on the sideline, getting ready again. We'll be back after these messages on Network West Virginia. So they now have the free kick, and they'll take it from their own 20-yard line. And Princeton's really moving up. They want to take advantage of what could be some really good field position.
And it looks like Bluefield is going to take a timeout and discuss to see whether they want to run the ball or kick the ball.
Didn't make it through. As they take this timeout, we'll take a timeout. We'll be right back with more high school football on Network West Virginia. Close to a capacity crowd at Hunnicutt Field in Princeton. We've got our rivals, the Princeton Tigers, the Bluefield Beavers. The Beavers have just accidentally given up 2 points. That is a hard way to go when you center the ball just low enough that your kicker has to kneel down to get it. That's tough. Number 11, Cornelius, kicking off. They're kicking it for a very dangerous man. Gardner's got the ball. He just says, go right in the middle, and he's finally taken down by number 33 on that nice return. Marcel Myers does it for Bluefield. Put on the West Virginia Army National Guard replay. Nice kickoff, booted it deep, and Gardner showing some good speed. And boy, he's got good upfield vision. Nice job by the return team. And he almost eats students all. You watch right there, he goes a long way before he stops and just barely misses it. The coverage team from Bluefield that just took him out the knee, but excellent starting position.
Wonderful field position for the Tigers, first and 10, operating at Bluefield's 46-yard line. The offense has done their job moving the ball. The offense has also had their problems with the penalties. Belcher, hands off. He's got a big guy behind him in front of him. Number 7, Hayes. And the ball fumbled. And the referee saying that Bluefield has recovered. The man coming up with the ball looks like, I think it's number 88 for Bluefield. Let's take a look at it. The West Virginia Army National Guard replay.
Boy, and really big mistakes on penalties and turnovers here in the first half. We just saw Bluefield give one away on the kneel down in the end zone for the safety, and just like that, after a big run, struggling for more yardage. Watch on the West Virginia Army National Guard replay. Boy, he was close to being down, but the officials right on there, and we saw 4 beanbags come in, so you know 4 officials aren't going to miss that.
Maurice Jordan knocked the ball loose and then picked it up. Bluefield now back in action. McClanahan. There's timeout on the field again.
It looks like we got an official timeout. Oh, yeah. Looks like an equipment problem.
Hayes is coming off the field. No, he's not. I would hope that we wouldn't be replacing an offensive defensive lineman for a defensive back. But we did have some equipment problems. I think he lost his mouthpiece, and they said, go pick it up before we can move on with the game.
So anyway, we got that covered now. Waiting for the official to start the play clock again. This has been a long first quarter. Still have 3 minutes and 7 seconds to go, and we've got a timeout on the field.
I believe all the referees want to use their flags, and all the rep coaches want to use their timeouts. The current score, Princeton 9, Bluefield 0. We're at another timeout right here on Network West Virginia. And it's just over 30 minutes in this first quarter of real time, and we still have 3 minutes left on the clock, the game clock.
You know what that equals to? A long drive home late tonight.
Times at least 15 of us. A flea flicker. Number 28, the halfback, Maurice Jordan, had the ball, and that pass was intended for his wide receiver breaking pass down the right side of the field.
And it looked like he was initially open. He went to the West Virginia Army National Guard replay, and he lays it out there ahead of the receiver. Gardner does a good job, the safety, coming over and making up space on that one.
Transcendental ponder, and he did not have the legs to get that far out. That was a little overthrown.
So nice throw for a tailback.
Both teams have been running well up the middle. I can't believe they're abandoning that on a 9-0 lead because both teams are also making mistakes. Direct snap
You can see he had one of your line that pulled out for Princeton. The defensive line does a good job breaking that up, and he couldn't get out there to lead block. But Hayes doing a good job picking up a couple extra yards after contact.
You get the idea that these, a lot of players on these two teams know each other.
And probably don't care for each other a lot either.
First half, it's Princeton 16 and Bluefield 7.
done a great job. And you know, this is such a big game in Mercer County, you might want to order this game on VHS tape.
And how did you do that?
I'm glad you asked. If you'd like to have your own VHS copy of tonight's game, send a check or money order. Pennies, we don't care, but for $20, the high school football care of Charter Media, 300 Star Avenue, Suite 340 on Martinsburg, West Virginia, 6101, or call 304-422-6088. For PAM, for CBS, Visa, MasterCard, American Express, if you got the money, we'll let it go. $19.95, and plus, you're going to have to pay for it.
Here the last couple of series, I would take it at the 35. Let's not do anything.
number four, Phillip Finley. And Finley really does a good job. It's like, oh, that's all you have to know. Coach Spadaro is doing a nice job of mixing it up. Working on the West Virginia Army after a replay. They've been hitting on the outside with a switch. This time, a direct handoff to the fullback. He goes right up over his right guard, right tackle. And there was a huge hole to run through. And just like that, they've got it 2 yards short of midfield.
After running wide so many times, we'll play inside, caught Bluefield off guard. It's first down for the Princeton Tigers. The ball now in their own 47-yard line. Milcher hands off and makes a nice move. Number seven, Marcus Hayes. He's finally stopped. There are people still floating on the field and being thrown down.
A little bit of words being passed around out there. Watch on the West Virginia Army Ashbury replay. A nice move right there by Hayes to get himself some positive yards. He's going to pick up about three on the play. And really created some space there for himself. You can see right there, that's what everybody's complaining about. Extracurricular tugging and pulling after the whistle.
But Joyner from Bluefield wanted to make sure that he wasn't going to go any further than that. Number 31, Chase Joyner did a good job of stopping that play. Belcher under center. Behind him again, Finley. Little trickery, double fake handoff. And Belcher keeps the ball in the defense of Bluefield.
And that was a good job. Watch on the West Virginia Army National Guard replay. Watch Alan Carter. Well, Alan Carter was in and missed on the play.
The defense would not give up on that one.
That was Alan Collins, number 63. The defensive end did a good job turning that play back to the inside and then making the tackle. He's your defensive end that's going to play the wide side of the field.
Third and long. Handoff goes wide to the right. The running back, number one, Gardner. He stretches for everything he's worth, but he's going to be well short of that first down.
And a good job by Bluefield. They bent a little bit, gave up some yards on that play. They didn't break. It's going to bring up fourth down from the 45-yard line, and it looks as if Princeton is going to punt.
Was that a whole series without a flag? I'm starting to.
You know, I think you're right. I'm not going to swear to it, but I don't think I saw the yellow flag fly on any of those three plays.
Number 21, Testa, back to punt. Back to receive for Bluefield, the number one guy that wants to pick it off, Jonathan Payne. It's a fake.
Well,
it did not work. It did not fake out Bluefield.
Yeah, they tried a direct snap to the end, man. What's on the West Virginia Army National Guard replay? 1-800, go guard. They tried a direct snap to the up man. What's right here? And it was high. Well, that's the punter. Trust me on this. It was high. Went off his hands. He had to go to his right to pick it up. And Bluefield was all over. So even if the play had been set up correctly, it couldn't be executed because of the bad snap.
I think you noticed when they came off the field, Brandon Croy, number 21, number 27, actually was saying, it was a little high, a little bit behind me.
Not my fault. So that worried. We see two bad snaps on punts off each team.
They're using the same format they did the last time they had the ball. Bluefield's number 20, Maurice Jordan, is lining up as the quarterback now. And he runs the ball to the right side of the defense. And it looks like Princeton gave up about three on the play.
Yeah, he did. Princeton does a good job of stringing that out. And it looks right now like they're going to send Taylor to the sideline.
And we've now got back in Eric McClanahan, the starting quarterback. The quarterback's actually now back in the game. Behind him is their big fullback, number 22, Alan Carter, lining up under center. He gives it to Carter right up the middle. Get out of my way, rumbling, stumbling. Big guy, number 22, Carter, makes the first. Moving to the deep back this time, right to the near side, number three,
still in bounds and rode him out of bounds and brought him down. The official, you can see, is right there on top of it. And the coaches are coming in and saying, boys, shut your mouth. Let him go back on the field. We don't want to give him 15 free yards here.
Not in this position. We've got a second down and 12 yards to go for Bluefield. The ball now resting on the Princeton 32-yard line, 33-yard line. 7:10 left to go in the first half. This time the running back Maurice Jordan. Jordan tries to take it up inside the left tackle. Brought down by number 88, Matt Pendick for the Tigers.
Good job by the defensive end. Turning him inside, coming back and making the tackle. And that is so important. It's one of the things that are overlooked, your defensive ends. That's one thing that two things they need to do. Stay at home. If the play goes the other way, it might be a misdirection coming back your way. And if that play is going outside, try to turn it back into your help. And he kind of did just that. Good job, only picking up a yard for Bluefield.
Bluefield. Quarterback Flanahan sees his man open, throws the ball, and his intended receiver, number 42, Travis Tiptoe, is unceremoniously interrupted in his pass reception by Marcus Hayes.
Welcome to the West Virginia Army National Guard replay. And Hayes tries to go right through the receiver instead of going around him. He went right through him, right into his back, and the official is standing out there. And that's not a hard call to make. He's only looking at two guys, and it's hard to hide when you're out there all by yourself. A good call by the official, because Hayes did go right through the receiver to knock that ball free.
But it wasn't that close. Hayes was about a step and a half off. And you're right, he tried to go through him instead of playing the ball itself. He was definitely playing the receiver.
Yeah, that's what you need. You need to go to around the receiver, your lead hand, and try to knock the ball down that way. And that was just not what you want your cornerback doing.
Oh, this is a big help for the Bluefield Beavers. The penalty brings the ball to the Princeton 14-yard line.
So Bluefield, after starting at their own 20, has slowly moved the ball up the field, doing a good job. They've got it up to 15, just past the 15-yard line.
Under center for Flanahan. He hands it off to big number 22, Alan Carter again. If you want to get 4 yards, give it to him, because he'll hit somebody and then stretch out, and there's four automatically.
And a good job. Watch Carter, he just hits a pile right here and just starts pushing forward and does a good job. Boy, he is a big kid. I remember a few years back, Princeton had a big running back guard by the name of Will Alvin.
Yes.
And Alvin looked to be a little bit more athletic, but a big kid, not quite as big, but boy, he was big through the shoulders, and he could punish some people when he ran up the middle.
Under center, McClanahan once again, Carter behind him, and they're going to give it to Carter again. He says hello to everybody on the Princeton defense. And he hasn't given up. They have blown the whistle dead. I don't think they ever truly got him down. They forced him back away. But Carter is a junior, 6 feet less than 6 foot, 263 pounds.
I believe it's 263 pounds. He looks that big. Worked on the West Virginia Army National Guard replay. Good job. He gets stood up at the line. But boy, 263 pounds is hard for one guy to stop. And then you get two, three guys coming over. And the whistle blew dead. That's the reason why he had stopped. They stopped the score in progress right there. It's going to be third.
One wide to the left. The plan in the center of the snap. Oh, Mr. He is met this time. It was not Mr. Carter. That was number 42, Travis Tiptoe. He was well into the far end of the field by the defense of Princeton.
And also, watch number 64, Harry Lask. He gets in on the tackle. Oh, a lot of help there.
Looks like number 52, Jared Collins, was in there with him. They made a point with that stop.
And that was a good job by the middle of that Princeton line. They knew two plays up the middle to come at him for 9 yards. They figured, well, they're probably going to come back one more time trying to pick up that 1 yard, and they couldn't do it. Ended up losing a yard.
We've got fourth and a long two, so Bluefield's taking a timeout. Want to talk this one over.
Somebody that's really good and somebody that's not, and they always end up finding the canvas. actually. That's my favorite part.
My favorite part is just finding out what round it is.
I think I know what you mean. Somebody hold the card up.
We are back in the play. It looks like they're going to attempt a field goal. The Bluefield Beavers on to make the attempt. It is their kicker, Sean Cornelius. He puts it up. And it's good. Just inside the left upright.
24-yard field goal.
With 4 minutes, 36 seconds left on the clock, it's made it closer. It's Princeton 16, Bluefield 10. This is your high school football game of the week on Network West Virginia. It's going to be an easy schedule for the Tigers of Princeton.
No, it isn't. And that's one thing about the Mount State Athletic Conference. I mean, there are good teams throughout the state, but the toughest conference in the state by far, I think, my own personal opinion, is the Mountain State Athletic Conference. They always seems like they send 5 or 6 teams to the playoffs every year. It just seems like they end up beating up on each other, and some good team doesn't end up making the playoffs.
Cornelius to kick off, but he's kicking it short again. They don't want it back in the hands of the wrong people, and it's almost in the hands of the wrong people. The upbacks for Princeton fumble that ball up in. It looks like they've been safely taken it to the ground, covered it. Princeton will start right there on their next offensive series on their own 34.
Boy, that was a good play. They just didn't get back to cover. You go back to that field goal by Bluefield. I know a lot of Bluefield fans are probably saying, what are you doing? We've got a yard and a half. Let's go for it. Let's get the points saved. Let's get the touchdown. I like that call, though. They got the field goal. They closed it within 6 points. So now if they can just hold here, which is something they've had trouble doing tonight, holding the Princeton offense, if they can hold here, get a touchdown before half and the conversion, they can go in with a 1-point lead.
Number one, Gardner, and it looks like Gardner's had enough for the first and out. Number four, Philip Finley, running that ball for Princeton. He must have picked up two or three on just sheer guts.
Yeah, it's pretty much, you wouldn't hold on to run there. He just lowered his head and started tapping his legs, and he's going to pick up about 3 yards out of the play.
Seconds roll off the clock here at Hunnicutt Stadium.
five-score halftime. It's Princeton 16, Bluefield 10. You're watching the high school football game of the week on Network West Virginia.
When you do this, Princeton, because you're giving, or Bluefield, because you're giving Princeton a chance to intercept the ball and make the return.
And you get the ball halfback, Maurice Jordan, honest quarterback, a late substitution, a flag on his field, an illegal substitution on Bluefield. But going back to that, why Bluefield would want to do this, because it's really the bad outweighs the good as far as I'm concerned on this play, because they can throw an interception, he can be sacked, fumble the ball, Bluefield takes it into the end zone. There's a ton of bad things that can happen, and you might just give away 7 points here at the end of the half with 1 second left. But a lot of coaches don't like to take their timeouts into the locker room with them. Maybe that's what Bluefield was feeling.
He's not going to, he has done that.
But there was, you're right, there was nothing good going to happen because the Princeton D-backs were standing way back and saying, you can pass in front of me all you want, you're not going to get me out of
it. And now it's like, after all that, Bluefield.
Thank you, we're going to have time.
This the second half. Welcome back to A&S Hunnicutt Stadium in Princeton, West Virginia. This week's high school football game of the week, Princeton against Bluefield on Network West Virginia. John Below along with Ron Cook, and I'm substituting for Brian Noss, and I'm sure everybody out there will be glad to hear that Brian will be back next week.
As far as I know, yes, he will be back. I make no guarantees, though.
Now, if I have him back next week, we have to renegotiate an entire multi-million-dollar contract.
Wait a second. I'm going to ask for more. You know, we were talking about during halftime where it looked like Princeton had control of the game. We didn't realize until we got the stats how much they really did have control of the game.
Oh, Princeton Tigers ran 26 times for 228 yards in that half. Bluefield 20 times for 81 yards.
So, you know, I mentioned that Bluefield's going to feel fortunate to only be down by six. They got to really feel fortunate to only be down by six. I mean, Princeton, after just watching the game, I would have never guessed that they had almost 3 times the rushing yards. But boy, they really dominated, and to only be up by six, Princeton sort of, they're going to be scratching their heads, you know, saying, boys, we got to cut the penalties out, we got to cut the turnovers out, and when we get down to the 30-yard line, we got to keep it going.
I tell you, neither one of the passing games have been prolific, to say the least. 7 attempts for Bluefield for 1 reception of 27 yards. 5 attempts for Princeton for 1 completion for 9 yards. So we better not hope that they're putting everything on the backs of the quarterbacks to throw it downfield. Ready now for the kickoff of the second half for Princeton number 21, Manuel Testa, is going to kick it off. Hercey for Bluefield picks up that ball and then basically slides safe for a tackle.
Watch on the NetworkWestVirginia.com replay. See right there, he almost loses his footing as he feels as he takes in the ball, and then he's going to lose his fielding there and lose his footing on the field. And you know, we've seen before here in the mountains, nice cool evening, starting to cool down, that dew is starting to settle on the grass, and that may have been the problem there. Put him down, and they're going to die.
Looks like number 31 there, Mark.
they pick up a first down on that play.
I was going to say, Page not only found the ball, I could have sworn I saw him use forward. Picking up the first down, first and 10, Bluefield, 11-41 to go on a moving block here in the third quarter.
At first, he tried to pick it up and run with it, and then just fell on it.
Successful.
averaging 11.6 yards a carry in the first half. Third and 14 for the Tigers at the 25. Belcher takes the ball, moves it to his left. He's looking to throw.
West Virginia.com replay.
snap. Belcher gives it up to Croy again.
West Virginia.com replay. All that is a handoff right middle. He gets hit right.
knows how to bring knees up and turn and move nothing but forward.
Jordan's coming across the field, and boy, this is just a nice catch. We got to go up high. If he doesn't catch it, that ball's in.
there for Princeton would have come up with the ball, but it's about 3 yards short of the first down. So even after a nice catch by Jordan, Bluefield's going to have to punt the ball. And that's one thing they don't want to do is give the ball back to Princeton. And that is the third quarter into the third quarter.
Some guards pulling out in front of him. He's also got some backs out in front of him. And look at the wall they just set up.
receiver of Princeton.
Thank you.
was behind that guy that was standing up for that camera. Oh, Hercey put the tackle there, and they took it in the end zone from there.
Yeah, for the cameras to be more airtime than we are. Actually, it was a beautifully run play. What we're looking at here is the fact that Hercey had everything shifted to the left at that time, the left side. But Red Bluefield has shifted everything with him, and when he cut back,
seems to be a little more moist. They seem to have
there cramping up on people. It looks like he's grabbing his hamstring. And, you know, they're getting so late in the game, down by 14 points, or down by 12 points. How many times can they go for it? He's inconsistent. He has like 4 or 5 yards every time he touches the ball. And getting late enough in the game where you keep doing that, you've got a long way to go on the field. It's going to chew up too much time.
You got some big boys here now. There's a timeout called. I think they are worried about Carter. Bringing out some fluid. In that lineup, they had all sorts of people coming out. They had Carter in the backfield. They had the other big fullback, Travis Tesso, actually in the slot position. And you wonder how much damage. You'll see Stepto, he is measured as 5'10", 225-pound slot man is going to do for you in this situation.
Yeah, well,
for a very fast coming this way, they've got a big guy in the lead block.
You know, one thing that's surprising tonight, we really haven't seen any of the Princeton players experience the cramping. You know, we've seen two or three guys from Bluefield, and it looks like they're getting just a little bit worn down. It looks like conditioning may be playing in, and also the size, you know, the way Princeton started that game out, just pounding them in the middle, you know, maybe taking their toll on that Bluefield team right now.
I was in the Bluefield locker room as they arrived. They did not show up here at the stadium until about 6:15 or 6:20. They were already dressed, and Coach Fred Simon, I know, had them ready, but you kind of wonder how much stretching and stuff went on since they came pretty close to the time you really need to be out there getting yourself ready.
You know, we got an away game. Most coaches like to get their boys there early, have plenty of time to get in the locker room, get situated, then you get your pads on and everything, come out, warm up. A lot of teams will come out without their pads on, do a little running and stretching, you know, like 2 hours before the game, then go back and get your pads on and everything, get ready for the game.
Same lineup they had. No, this time they got Jordan in the backfield as the quarterback. He just threw a pass to number 54. Am I right? They threw it to 54. Isn't that a lineman? Number 64.
Either way, 64 is Harry's voice. It doesn't matter. And the only way if he is tied in and has reported in,
I don't think so.
Well, I would say he was lined up on the end. I don't know. But what happened, that play was designed up. They had a 5-yard out and a 10-yard out. Jordan had no one to throw to, and then he sort of panicked and looked for the first open white shirt he had. That's illegal touching, and that was the wrong guy to throw to.
As a high school player, you don't want illegal touching. As a high school person, you don't want illegal touching.
Yes, you can see right there, he is lined up in the tackle position. He is not a tight end.
And Jordan turns and says, oh, there he is.
He was probably as shocked as anybody on the field that ball was coming at him.
And Mr. Terrence Williams said, I'll catch it. It'll be the only time in my life he throws to me. I will catch the ball. But it's illegal.
After the loss on the play and the penalty, Princeton will decline it. They're going to bring up fourth down and 12, and they're going to make Bluefield punt the ball. 7 minutes and 34 seconds to go in the ball game. That clock started winding down as the official started it, and Bluefield, not a good shape, will have to punt the ball now.
Jim Hughes and the kicker gets up underneath the ball. Once again, as they're being tossed, Preston moves away from the ball. The ball takes a lateral bounce right out of bounds to the 40-yard line. Princeton starts in great shape. First and 10, Bluefield is 40. With timeout on the field, we'll take this timeout right here on Network West Virginia. And ball forward on the snap. Nice carry. It looks like he is so close to the first down on that one.
So he's coming up a little lame on the play. One thing we've noticed a change, Princeton has started to change out there. They're running out of that power eye formation. Got their big guard playing in the backfield, and that time he went to motion. Watch on the NetworkWestVirginia.com replay. You can see he went in motion to the left-hand side of the line. They go back to the right. He had a nice little run through. Picks up almost 10 yards. They're going to bring out the sticks and measure that one.
They use big number 51, Keith Taylor, who they put in the backfield. He's a guard on the list here. They used him as a fake this time. He goes left. All the linebackers go with him.
Yes, this is going to that power eye formation. He's pretty much where he's going. The ball's gone. Princeton, and that has worked for them.
As long as they haven't hurt themselves, Bluefield hasn't done much hurting. First and 10 was achieved on that play. Number 5, Belcher, the quarterback. We have the same power formation. Taylor, the big man, in motion. And we're going to go right behind him. But guess what? Number 4, Jeremy Kessan, who's also their kicker and D-back, decided, I know which way they're going. I'm going to step in front. Well, look on the NetworkWizardsGeek.com replay. Kessan does a great job. He's going to beat the block right there. And that puts him all alone in the backfield with Hayes, and he does a good job. Now, Hayes used that tackle on somebody else. He hang on to the ankle and wait till quick for help. Kessan does the same thing and brings it out for a huge loss. It's going to be 2nd and 18.
But the block keeps moving, and that's in favor of the Princeton Tigers.
The handoff to the big man of the evening. Number 27 for Princeton. Brandon Croy is carrying everybody, and it's another successful play and another first down for the Tigers.
Limited to 3 carries in the first half. He has been their workhorse in the second half and has really had some big runs and a big touchdown run earlier. What's your home network? West Virginia.com replay. Conference, if they were in the Mount State Athletic Conference, if they were in the starting to cramp up and get tired. That has an effect on the whole team.
Jordan back at quarterback. And I believe we got motion on the offensive line. They have done something unusual. They have been switching the lower halfback, Maurice Jordan, with the quarterback, Eric McClanahan. Now, McClanahan was not their starting quarterback for the year. It was J.T. Powell. Powell did a great job last week. And when he got knocked out of the game against Virginia,
lineman a lot when they chase a quarterback around. regardless of the ball being gone for 2 or 3 seconds. And that's going to cost him 15. I don't think where he caught the ball, they would have been short by first down by about a yard and a half, 2 yards. But with that 15 yards tacked onto it, that'll be his first down. And Bluefield will have the ball, have a 4 minutes and 30 seconds to go.
Lets her go, and he gets it to number 42, Travis Stewart. motion, and Bluefield, just like that, has got the ball down to the 11-yard line. We've got a injured Princeton player down. Looks like he's got a cramp.
Yeah, they're moving that knee. They might get a little knee jumping in there. They're testing it. Hopefully nothing serious. But Bluefield's coach said that they obviously need to use less time. They need to go to air. And by going to the air, they're not throwing it to a receiver. You're right. They're throwing it to a spot and hoping that their receiver, knowing who the hot man is on the route, has more chance of cutting and making it to that spot than the defensive player does.
And, you know, really, it was good coverage by the Princeton secondary. But on a pass like that, you know, good coverage turns into one quick cut away from you going to the open ball and you lose the defender like that. That was Nick Harrell. He came, got up off the field. Nick Harrell's had a good game tonight for Princeton.
He's done a little bit on offense, a little bit on defense. He's been very steady for them. Under center, McClanahan. He's going to let it go to the end zone. The corner. Oh, it was in the hands of number 19, Ansel Ponder. And it's knocked away. Number 34, looks like Chris Anderson went over and knocked it down.
I think it was number 24, Wilburn. He went right there just at the last second. He caught it, had it in his hands. Nice job on the Virginia.com replay. But you can see he just, it would have been a touchdown, but at the last second he came over his shoulder, went past interference, and did a good job knocking that ball out of his hands.
That was number 24, Q. Wilburn. Less snap. Rolls to his left, throws it back across the grain, and he was very lucky that Gardner did not come up with an interception there. So, good job by the Princeton secondary. That time, you know, when you get down, once you get to the goal line, the harder it is to pass. It gets more congested down there.
And luckily for Bluefield, that pass was lower. It may have been picked off. Hey, he was really trying to thread the needle on that one, get it into his receiver. That's going to bring up third down and 10 for Bluefield. 2:08 to go in the ballgame.
Sure, we're in four down territory.
That would be my guess.
2:08 left on the clock. Planahan, the shotgun, hands it off. Number 3, Payne. Jonathan Payne goes around the right side. We haven't called Payne's number a whole lot this afternoon. He was on board for the first half.
Yeah, he was. And just that Princeton secondary, except for a couple of big plays, had the big one over. Had the big run, and besides that, they have really stepped up and played good defense in the second half and really limited Bluefield. I mean, Bluefield scored, you know, 4 more points than they have in the first half, but it seems like Princeton's defense has played better at special teams.
Fourth and 10 for Bluefield. This is a game basically for them. Lobs it up once again into that corner position, and it's fought for, and it looks like the Princeton player has come down with it. It was a tug of war out there, and number 24, Hugh Wilborn, comes down and intercepts that ball.
And it looked like Ponder had got the ball in the end zone. Watch on the WestVirginia.com replay. It looked like Ponder catches this ball. It's just a fade to the corner, and he's got it in his hands, but boy, a good job by Wilborn. Just wrestling that ball away from him, and he wanted it more than Ponder did, and he comes up with it.
Great replay on that one, because Ponder spun, is falling back toward the turf, and Hugh is still standing there, jerking up on the ball. That's basically what hits the ball for him, is the fact he's still standing.
And he probably given away 6-7 inches to Ponder,
but at least 50 pounds.
Yeah, and just proved he wanted that ball more than Ponder did. It just takes it right away from him.
Princeton doesn't want to do anything extravagant here. They're on the 5-yard line, first and 10, with only a minute 19 left to go. So they give it right. Give it right to number 27. Troy, man of the hour, Troy, Brandon Troy. And as he's going down, he toss up the ball. His arm reaches out, gets it right back
on top of it. Matthew Carter. That's going to keep the clock wide, and he had a nice old run through. He picks up a first down. And Troy has really been, you can see right there on the network, WestVirginia.com replay, does a good job. That ball just squirted right out, and it couldn't have stopped in a better place, and he fell right on top of it.
Troy says, I've had a good night, and I'm not ending it with a fumble. First and 10 for Princeton. This time, the handoff goes to Johnson. Johnson's got the speed, and they force him outside. It looks like he picks up enough for a
side of the goal. What's here on the network? Look at that block, just driving the page right out of the line. And then, that insult to injury. It looks like the Princeton Tigers have good backs. But what I've been impressed with tonight is their offensive line play. They don't win on any play until the opposition lineman is on his back. They did a great job on that screen pass, upfield blocking there, and with it, just really good fluid. The guards pull well. They've just done a great job. They've looked good all night tonight.
First and 10. And they're
I'm not sure all the Princeton fans like that. We heard some comments out of the stadium crowd here because they feel better. Hey, 7 more points, it's 50-24. Here is that Princeton winning 43-24. The fans saying it's not enough. They've had enough losses to this Bluefield team. They want a big win.
Well, 43-24 is a pretty big win.
No, they want it. If you give a Princeton an eighth and a half a mile, they'll take a mile. They want 60. This 14 seconds left to go. This is probably the last play of the game. And sure enough, the quarterback, Chris Belcher, takes one knee.
Finally, the quickness and size of Princeton finally took over, and they win their game.